I'm Megan Mitchell, Academic Engagement and Digital Initiatives Coordinator at the Oberlin College Library. I'm going to give an overview of the scholarly publishing platform called Scalar. Scalar bills itself as born digital, open source, media-rich, scholarly publishing that's as easy as blogging. It was developed at the University of Southern California by the Alliance for Networking Visual Culture, which set out to create a platform for interactive, multimodal publications that leverage digital mass media and also to cultivate relationships among scholars, university presses, libraries, and archives. It was built with grant funding from the Andrew W. Mellon Foundation and the National Endowment for the Humanities. Scalar was released in 2013 with major updates in 2016 and 2019. I mentioned a moment ago that Scalar is open source. This means that the developers have made the source code freely available for others to install, modify, and improve. There are several ways that you could get access to Scalar. You could sign up for a free account at the University of Southern California, ask your digital initiatives librarian for an account at your library, or you could set up Scalar yourself if you have web hosting. So who is using Scalar? Individuals are using it to create full-length books and also media companions to print publications. Cultural heritage institutions, libraries and archives, museums are using it for exhibitions. Academics are using it increasingly for class projects. Scalar strengths include the fact that no programming skills are required in order to make use of the platform. It's well suited for both long-form prose and visual exhibitions. It easily facilitates collaborative authorship. It employs the Dublin Core metadata framework, which is a widely adopted flexible schema for describing all kinds of objects. And it offers many options for featuring media. There are several different ways to get media into a Scalar project. You can use the built-in importers to harvest files and metadata from affiliated archives and other compatible open archives, or you can upload your own files, either from a hard drive or the web, one at a time or in batches. Scalar offers a variety of page layouts. You can have pages that are just images, just text, text and images interspersed, or use third-party programs like Google Maps or timelines. Another feature of Scalar is the annotation tools, which allow you to add value to the media by zeroing in on parts of images, audio files, and videos, and adding notes to them. In this example, the text links to an audio file for which the clip is set to start at a specified time, and the author has added notes for the listener. A unique feature in Scalar are the visualizations. All types of content in a Scalar book, text, media, tags, can be visualized in the platform. And these visualizations can be used in other places in the book. And Scalar does all of that hard work for you. There is a learning curve for taking advantage of all the bells and whistles and creating nonlinear paths within Scalar. Compared to other platforms such as WordPress, for which there are thousands of themes available, there are fewer customization options in Scalar. And there's limited technical support. Since it is open source software, there is no 1-800 number to call when things go wrong. And there's not currently an organized user community like the Omeka Forum. Scalar makes it possible for anyone to create an attractive, fully functional ebook in a relatively short amount of time. If you have time for experimentation and further planning, you can create something truly sophisticated and engaging. To learn more or get started with Scalar, contact your Digital Initiatives librarian.